Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome back to Delta Force 2. Now, something happened. Satellite imagery over the South Pole more or less showed us that some terrorists had broken into a containment unit of biological agents. And when Delta Force was sent there, even though I suppose it was a task for the Arctic Commandos, but then again, I could be wrong. I think Arctic Commandos are only really active in the North Pole. Again, I think I feel like I've talked about this back in Delta Force 1 with the Nova Assembly missions as well, but anyway, I digress. In this case, the terrorists took some scientists hostage and stole a bunch of biological agents that could be used for warfare, biochemical warfare. So we tried to track them down, and I don't know how we managed to do that, but or rather how intelligence managed to do that, but they have tracked them down all the way to the country of Uganda, as far as I'm sure. Yeah, Uganda. So apparently there's an airfield, like a militant airfield that we need to until where the viruses have been tracked. Assumably, since they are at an airfield, they are being shipped to elsewhere, another part of the world. So it's important for us right now to actually go ahead and get rid of the people in the airfield and reacquire the virus samples. The virus has been tracked to an airfield in Uganda. Infiltrate the enemy base and search for the virus.
Although we were unable to recover the virus, we have learned much from the captured staging base. Intelligence indicates that a paramilitary group called Da'Nil masterminded the attack. They plan on using the virus as leverage for future demands. We have tracked the plane believed to be transporting the virus to a small airfield in the Republic of Uganda. Your objective is to secure the airfield and search the aircraft for the package. Bravo will insert west of the airfield and proceed in on foot. Alpha and Charlie will converge on the objective from the north and east, respectively. U-2 overflight shows light defenses at the field. You should be able to get in and out before anyone knows you're there.
So, yeah, that's the briefing. I mean, one of the things about the briefings in this game is that in Delta Force, they were far more realistic and accurate, and they actually, like, talked about an action plan for the situation at hand. They first gave you the situation at hand, and then they talked about how they were planning on dealing with it, even though sticking to it was completely your choice, and usually sticking to it was not the optimal path. They still gave you an action plan to follow. In this game, it's more like just, oh yeah, that's the story, and yeah, that's it. You don't really get anything apart from that. Now, one of the things that I like about this game is how it makes the Ghillie Suit makes it so much easier to sneak about. So I'm going to be taking Ghillie Suit, and I'm going to be taking a suppressed pistol. Suppressed rifle sucks. It still sucks in this game. I mean, I feel like it's a little bit better than Delta Force, but it still does suck in this game because you have no scope and the bullet drop is crazy. So at any rate, we are going to be taking the M4 carbine with the grenade launcher attachment. We will be needing that for this level, and the 45 unsuppressed. Now, wish me luck.
Excuse
me, I'm standing here. So are you two guys really just here only for the extraction? I mean, don't you guys have anything else to do? Anyway, there are a few people upstairs that we need to take care of now. The fact that I'm wearing the ghillie suit means that the enemy combatants will not know where I am. While I take them out at my leisure. Excuse me. I'll just wait for the lag to stop. Yeah, thank you. In case you guys can't tell, there's one guy right standing up there. And yeah. The thing about this game is that... Did that guy die? Or is he still alive? Yeah, he's dead now. there are people here. But I noticed this in the first game as well. I suppose this was one of the early implementations of how stealth is supposed to work. Oh damn, that was a hard hit, wasn't it? But yeah, the enemies can't really tell where you are. If what was that? That guy's dead. Now for this guy, wherever he might be. And he's dead. Now, the problem with this is the damage fall-off. The damage fall-off is something else. I don't really want to talk about it as much, but it is egregious, so to speak. Although I doubt egregious is the right word for it, I'm just going to lay down. That's going to make my profile just that much more difficult to detect. Although I don't know whether it actually works that way in this game. And I do believe my friends are now infiltrating. I don't know whether that is Charlie. Yeah, that is Charlie. He actually does come over to help. And
Alpha team, moving in!
Roger.
Bravo, you've got a shooter by the plane!
Yeah, I've got shooters all over the place. What are you talking about when you say by the plane? There's shooters here, there's shooters there, there's shooters.
Big six, Alpha One! We're at the objective and engage in the enemy!
Like, why the fuck is Charlie one down? And why is there not a medic with us? I mean, these guys are clearly asking for medics. Like, literally screaming out, medic, medic, when they get hit. Unless they're gurgling blood.
Alpha 1 is down!
Alpha 1 is down too. I mean, just look at these guys. These guys are not competent at all. Unless these guys are supposed to be, like, specially trained or something. Like the enemy. Which I doubt is the case. Now, there are some folks over here as well that we need to get rid of. Where did they go, the folks in here? That's one down. I'm just getting rid of all the glass there, so we know where the folks are. Oh, yeah. The people near the aeroplane. That's one down. Oh, somebody already got rid of the second one. Now, we need to be careful while descending because there's like a ditch with like a bunch of spikes in it that I more or less built myself onto.
Check each of the buildings and the aircraft for the package.
Roger, King 6. That's an enemy that I killed. The previous time around, there was somebody over here patrolling this area. Somebody shooting at me. I do not know from where. Since it stopped, I'm going to assume that whoever was shooting at me has lost line of sight at this point. Is that guy dead? Yeah, he is dead. Somebody shot at him from over yonder. I'm guessing that's Alpha. Alpha team. There are lots of folks inside these buildings, so it would be better if we are to maintain caution. Now, there are some spikes over here, which I impaled myself on the first time around that I played this level. More spikes here. You walk into them, you die. It's as simple as that. We also need to be careful while approaching this area here. Again, your ghillie suit will afford you a level of invisibility. Now, DG Voodoo isn't exactly perfect at upscaling this game. You can see in these instances where your weapon just more or less disappears. But this is the best available result that I got after trial and experimentation, like after trial and error. Because the first time around that I played this, look at that guy, just camouflaged into the terrain. I don't know whether that was on purpose or something, but could have done a better job, I feel like. You can hardly tell where they are unless you're using, like, the scope to zoom in. And if, God forbid, they actually manage to notice you before you notice them, in which case you will most likely be dying. Excuse me. Don't know if that caught anybody or not, but I'm hoping it did. That's the best I can do at this point. Oh, right. I forgot how this game has that feature. I'm pretty sure impact grenades will you know, work a little better when it comes to more or less impacting people. Definitely something there. And I just hope that they can shoot through walls. So, grenades in real life, like grenades that you launch from underbarrel grenade launchers, they're not supposed to explode up until a certain distance. And this game has that feature. I mean, you'll lose the grenade, that's for sure, but it won't. Like, you can't accidentally blow yourself up with that grenade. There was one more guy there who was shooting at me. Pretty sure there are far more. There are many more people here. I'm just gonna go or take like the longer way around to try and make sure that I don't die accidentally. Search the buildings and the aircrafts. Now, I am trying to do that. But I would much rather eliminate any unpleasant surprises first. You know, any of the unpleasant surprises that might be hanging around inside. Like that guy there. I suppose there are more unpleasant surprises inside of those bunkers there. And I fell down. Suffered some fall damage from it. Oh no. Hopefully that got rid of a few folks. A few of, you know, the malicious final folks. Yeah, those are Alpha 1 and 2. And they actually covered for me. I'm impressed. They actually covered for me the previous time around. Can I climb up? Thank you. There are most definitely more people here. Like that guy over there, who just spawned randomly. Who I couldn't even see before this point. Should take care of any... Okay, so there are graphical issues that are being presented, especially in this level. They just went away, but... They were being presented quite drastically up until now. I suppose all we can do at this point is just be careful. I see a target there. And I'm gonna take it. Should be a lot more folk in that hangar over there. Charlie one is down over in that section over there. Time to go check the buildings. Hopefully there aren't a lot of variables still remaining in this equation. Everything seems fine thus far. I cannot see any more hostiles. The Ghillie Suit is really a blessing in this game. Because it gives you like a lot of time before the enemy registers you as a threat. And that time, in a sense, more or less gives you the freedom to shoot them. Before they get a chance to shoot you. I do not think there are any more enemies here, but just erring on the side of caution here. I'm just gonna go ahead and...
Bravo, check the aircraft!
I thought I was supposed to check the buildings as well. Just gonna toss a few grenades in there just to be sure. For my sake. I do not think there are any people here. I do not see the virus sample unless it's supposed to be something that I can pick up. I just see some crates, most likely weapon crates, but I do not see any viruses here. The thing is, one of the requirements of this level is the fact that we do not need to eliminate all the hostiles. I just like to do that nonetheless because of how this game gets a little cranky when you don't eliminate all the hostiles. So there isn't really a way to move around along the back here. I cannot see any enemies in there either. And since there are no shots being fired, I'm just going to go ahead and risk it. If I die, I die. Okay, building number one. Time to go inside and check it. It's a hangar. But let's just call it a building, nonetheless. There are definitely rendering issues that you get with DG Voodoo. I thought I saw somebody there. Maybe there was somebody there. We'll find out once we get out. Strange. Nobody inside. Oh, come on. I'm out of grenade launcher ammo. What do you expect me to do? Check hand grenades in there? And I'm soon gonna be out of hand grenades too. Down to my last hand grenade. Let's hope that whoever was in there has been taken care of. No enemies in this building. You check that building already. I just hope there are none inside this. I do think there are, because... See? Somebody started shooting something. Excuse me. At least they also took care of the glitch where you could more or less just... And that's the end of my grenades too. Ah, somebody had already taken care of these guys, no wonder I didn't see them. Holy hell. You can climb up on these things now, that's amazing. Let me just go inside and check as well. No virus samples here. Approaching objective Cobra. I checked the plane. Unless there's like a more special way of checking it. There's another plane over here, which... I will probably need to approach cautiously again. Somebody's shooting at me, I cannot figure out who it is. Somewhere over there. I thought there was supposed to be a person there. I even blew up the barrels, but apparently that person was really durable. Had a lot of hit points. A simple barrel explosion did not kill him. Moving cautiously.
King 6, Alpha 2, the LZ is clear.
Is it? Is it? Well, this plane is clear at least. And there's nothing in here. What would you know? I think at this point we just go inside all of these buildings once and just, you know, look around, that's it. You don't need to do anything else. Charlie 2 is making his way down the hill because Charlie 1 is dead. poor guy. There's like a document there. I don't know what it says. Difficult to make out even with the zoom. Old style pixelated graphics for you. LZ is apparently clear, from what I've been told at least. Even though I did most of the clearing myself, I'm not really confident in my own abilities as a Delta Force operator. Now, here's what I Don't understand. There's like this extension section here which we cannot visit in. Which we cannot go and check out. Can I take one of these AKs? I really like AKs. Is that the virus sample? Oh yes, it is. Cool. So I guess at this point all we need to do is just more or less extract. Because I'm quite certain that there's nothing in here. Not as far as the eye can see. And I think that was all the virus samples that there were supposed to be in this level. I wonder what that is. Seems like something. Most likely foliage or some kind of tree, but you never know. You never know. No more virus samples here, from the looks of it. I honestly wish we could run faster, but this is the max speed. This is literally the maximum speed. Approaching objective Cobra, we have this is like walk. It's a CSGO mechanism. You can walk or you can jog. You can't sprint in this game. And I think this is the way to our extraction point. Oh no, it's this way. That was the infiltration point. Like, one of the infiltration objective markers. Huh. So once the action is over, this game actually gets pretty boring. Considering the walk speed. That's one point.
This is King 6. Looks like the package isn't here. Prepare to pull out. Black Widow, move in for the extraction.
What do you mean the package isn't here? I just found a sample of viruses.
King 6, Black Widow. Inbound to extraction point Zulu.
I just picked up a sample box of viruses. What are you talking about? Or was that something else? Like, was that supposed to be like... No, not really. Detonator. Impact frag grenade. What? Oh, that was a grenade case. I now have five more grenades. Okay, right. And that's... Free... yeah. Don't kill me, please. Thank you. And that's it. Again, no briefings whatsoever. But at this point in the campaign, two more missions have been unlocked. One is Demolition 101 and the other is Blindside. Now, from since I was confused about whether quick missions are part of the campaign, I did some independent research and it turns out from this point onwards, the story actually branches. And I don't know whether it branches in the same way that it does in Delta Force 1. But in Delta Force 2, I've heard that the story branches. I don't know whether once we choose one mission, we can complete the other one as well. But yeah, we gotta make a choice. And the choice shall be made when we come back. As for today's video, this is it. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for watching. And thank you for sticking around until the end. We apparently did not find the virus sample inside of the airfield, meaning that it has been transported elsewhere. Where is something that we will be figuring out later. And then there's also the matter of the hostages, which we need to, you know, essentially, we need to take care of the hostages as well. Get them before they die. That sort of falls under Delta Force 0 section. Anyhow, when we come back, we'll make a choice between Demolition 101. So basically, this is a choice between assaulting a vehicle depot and eliminating a communications hub. So I think between the two options, communications hub might just be the better target. Unless, I mean, I suppose we are crippling their mobility with one and we're crippling their coordination with the other. Although there are other means of communicating and there is of course a plan laid in place. So I think mobility might be the play here. So anyway, we'll decide that once we come back. Until then, thank you for tuning in. Take care. Farewell, fellow Earthlings.